This lesson is about the fear of public speaking. Let's face it, it's the reason a lot of people hate giving elevator speeches. And even the ones who do, that fear of public speaking holds them back from giving a great one. Well, first of all, if you have the fear of public speaking, you're not alone. Lots and lots of people share that fear with you. Estimates are that 75% of the population, to one degree or another, has that fear. And there is some comfort in numbers, although that doesn't solve your problem of the fear of public speaking. There's even a word for it. It's called glossophobia. It comes from the Greek, glosso, tongue, phobos, fear. But here's the good information. It's a word. It's not a disease. And it can be controlled. You don't want to get rid of it completely, and we'll talk some more about that. During my research about the fear of public speaking, I discovered that it is an equal opportunity fear. It doesn't care about your age, education, or occupation. I've coached doctors and lawyers, psychiatrists, presidents of companies, students, a father of the bride-to-be. I think he started getting panic attacks the day his daughter got engaged. So lots of people have this fear of public speaking. Well, why do we have it? Well, I usually answer that question by saying, why not? Think about it. Most of our conversation is one-on-one. A lot of it's on the telephone. You don't see the person. And more, people communicate by email or texting. You don't see or hear them. What stands to reason that if you get up in front of 10, 20, 40, 50 sets of eyeballs, you're out of your comfort zone. That's why you're uncomfortable. I know there are jobs like that that you might consider mundane. People love to hear about that. There's so many skills I don't have. I can't work with my hands. I'm the professional's best friend. A guy who is a plumber or a carpenter or an electrician or a mason, I admire those people. If they give an elevator speech and talk about what they do, I love to hear that. I'm in admiration of people who can do that kind of work, and I might hire them if I need that kind of work done. Those butterflies we have in our stomach. Well, we really don't want to get rid of them. If you've joined Toastmasters, you know what they say. We want to make them fly in formation. What we want to do is take that nervous energy and put it into our elevator speech. You know, an elevator speech without energy is boring. Anyone ever sit through a boring elevator speech? Well, here's something very important. Successful companies are customer focused. That would mean that medicine is focused on patients, education is focused on students, the hospitality industry is focused on their guests. Well, if you want to have a successful elevator speech, you need to be focused on the audience. It's all about the audience. It's not about you. Trust me. The audience came there to network. If you're networking one-on-one, they want to know what you do. Focus on the audience. Take it off you. And here's what you'll find out. This is one of the laws of presentation. You'll find when you're focused on your audience that the quality of your elevator speech will go up and your anxiety will be going down. Down quickly. And speaking of the audience, if you're up there giving your elevator speech, the audience is cheering for you. They want you to be successful. They feel for you. They're glad you're giving your elevator speech and not them. I mean, does anyone think the audience is sitting out there thinking, man, I can't wait till this guy messes up. I'm going to get on his Facebook page and diss that elevator. No. They want you to be successful. And if you mess up, they feel for you. So be audience-centered. That's one of the laws of presentation. Now, when we come back, I'm going to give you some nuggets to lessen that fear of public speaking. And when you do that, you're going to have a lot better elevator speech. Until then, practice, practice, practice. Take that content. Take the things we talked about in terms of delivery. Do that, and I guarantee your next elevator speech will be absolutely, positively, there's no doubt in my mind, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Your elevator speech will be no sweat.